Can the Tatara Muramasa live up to the hype? Stay tuned. This is Peter Charkalis with The Shaving Shop, as well as Ariana and Evans. And soon, Cobra Spit Bomb, the company. I just received this new Tatara Muramasa in the mail. Am I pronouncing that right? I think so. And delivery was super quick, really, really quick. I was quite interested in trying this out. You know, it's not inexpensive, but they're really nice guys, and I was very happy with my other Tatara, and I wanted to give it a go. So, here's the other one that I have, and we'll compare the two size-wise anyway, in case you're familiar with that. So, again, packaging. There's a magnet here, open it up. Inside you would see, actually, this. So instructions, some information about the product itself. There's five different settings within the product. So here's the razor, beautiful matte finish. You also have a key, which we'll get into in a second. But I'm gonna take out the razor. And so as far as comparison, so I forget what they call this, but the Muramasa is a little bit shorter, and I haven't set these on the scale, but they feel about roughly the same way just in my hand anyway. So it doesn't feel like a heavier razor, but here's the where you would see the settings. I don't know if you can see that. Now, if I had one complaint, razor's beautiful, but I'm 58 and I can't see the setting. Now I also wear glasses, so that certainly doesn't help. But I can't. Maybe if this was white with black lettering. Or you know, the black numbers. I don't know if that would be helpful, but in any case, let's give this a whirl. But before I do that, let's take it apart. So we're gonna unscrew the handle. Yep. So handle's unscrewed. Very simple. So three part. And if you wanted to use the key, so if you're interested in heavy duty cleaning, you can take that key, which was included, which I think is a brilliant idea. So if you want to do a deep cleaning and you want to take off this part here, it slides right in and you unscrew it. And then this piece comes off and then you can clean inside. So, great move on their part, just to give that added value and added benefit. I also will add that I ordered this, I paid full price. I didn't receive this for free, I didn't receive a discount, nothing like that. So I'm gonna insert a brand new Vashkod blade into the top. I just heard it click, I just clicked it in. We're going to insert it, clicked in, and then we're going to put in the handle. So this it's not cheap, it's not inexpensive. There's going to be a lot of comparisons made to the Rex. I'm sure people will find benefits to both. I think as far as design and aesthetics, I like this a lot. I think it's absolutely gorgeous. Looks like a work of art. Also, if I have a Rex, I left it at home, but I believe that the head design, I believe it's a shallower head design. And if that's the case, that will allow you to maybe get under the nose a little bit easier. This is also quite a bit more expensive, so it really depends on what you're looking for. This is at a level 5. This is actually a 5 setting, and if we were going to, I'm sorry, this is, that was at a low setting, and now it's at a larger gap, so you can see that. So that was a 0.9 gap. The soap I'm going to use is going to be the serum, my shave serum, which I haven't used in ages, and we'll go with an alpha shaving synthetic brush. Maybe I'll put it in the hand so you can see how much I'm putting in. So a little bit, and I'll just apply. So this is and I don't want to talk too much about this at all, but you can lather it or latherless. I should have rubbed the rest on the brush, but let's just start building.
All right, let's give it a go.
Now I could barely feel the blade. Let's check the setting on that again. There we go. Let's see if that makes a difference. Yeah. Again, because I can't see, now I can feel it much better. I can feel the blade now. So in comparison, the timeless that I have is a 0.95. That to me seems a little bit more aggressive. Does the 0.5 make that much of a difference? I don't know. But you can feel the blade for sure. Now, this is pretty aggressive, but I like aggressive razors. Now, under the nose. Yeah, no problem. No problem at all. I remember with the Future that I have, or had, great. Oh man, the sound that makes is unlike anything I've ever used before. But you'd always have to maneuver the nose to get underneath. Let's go with just another pass. Feels great. The weight distribution on that, it feels very, very, very good when you're holding it. Very well designed. Now, is it worth what I pay, $347? And would I do it again? So it's really hard to say with one shave, right? So this is just initial thoughts. But if you look at the total picture, the aesthetics, which is always important, the quality of the razor, is it something that's going to last? Packaging. What went into the design? The fact that it's an adjustable and unique at that. Yes, I would again, my first use, but I certainly don't regret purchasing this, and I would buy it again. But that doesn't mean it's for everyone, for sure. For those that are collectors, or want the latest and greatest, blah, 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 which I don't normally play into that anymore. I did. Those days are long gone. I can't remember last time I purchased a soap. But, and I've always been more into the software than the hardware, but this one really intrigued me. So, yeah. Does it live up to the hype? In my opinion, yeah, for sure. Great looking razor, great packaging, fast delivery. You know, all the things that, if you were looking to spend that kind of money, it certainly does. But again, it's not for everyone, and not everyone's going to buy it, which also makes it more attractive, right? So if everyone had, well, like a, I don't know, name a razor. I don't want to name razors, but name a razor that's quite inexpensive that everyone will want to buy because of the price point. It's good quality and blah, 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 blah. Yeah, but this is one of those that not everyone will have. But if you do, I'm certain you'll like it. So that's what I have for you today. Really pleased with it. I'm not gonna tell you go out and buy it. Look at it. Look at the price point. If you're comfortable with the price point, again, I think it was $347. Is it worth it? It's worth it if you're willing to spend that kind of money. If you're willing to spend that kind of money, I don't think you'll be disappointed. So go out and get it. All right. Take care, guys. All the best.